Well, that was disappointing. I thought we had some chances throughout the game to just play a little better, to be honest with you. But good teams can make you not play the way you want. Colorado played well. Defensively, their length and their quickness really caused some problems. I think their size inside was something we haven't seen in a long time, just with Ellie and Clarissa down there, who we rely on for some offense. You know, and they just kept making some big shots, especially in overtime. You know, I thought we defended okay, but they made some big shots, and we had a couple chances that just didn't quite go our way, too. So really appreciate Clarissa and Carrie and Ina, just three great seniors that have been with us for a long time and been a part of so many great memories. Wish we could have kept it going a little longer for them because they deserve it. They're such great Jackrabbits, but appreciate all that they've done. And then, this game was kind of like some of our other losses since Christmas. We just had so many of these that you'll look back on, or I'll look back on and wish – could have found a way to get a couple more baskets here or there. Season would have been, you know, completely different. So we were really close, but great year and feel good about everything we did for sure. So.
Kind of a tough third quarter, and then also the run right before halftime to cut it to one. Did either one of those feel more costly, or it seemed like that was kind of the key element to the game as far as them pulling away?
Yeah, I thought the second quarter, they just kind of took our wind, so to speak, out of the sails, and we didn't really recover well enough in that third quarter. Finally, late, we played with some urgency where you almost have to because you're back so far against the wall, and then you saw us make plays. You know, you saw a team that had purpose about us, but second and third quarter, we didn't quite have enough purpose, and I thought they started to trap a little bit of run and jump, and we didn't get comfortable like we did in that first quarter where we had the lead. But even so, we missed some shots. You know, I think we missed probably 3-4 just layups that normally you're going to make. We had a chance there late when the end of regulation to make a shot, didn't quite get it done. And we executed some good things to get back in it. I felt good about some of those things that we did, but just felt like we were really going uphill from about the beginning of that third quarter after they made their second quarter run. Felt like everything was kind of uphill for us.
You know, your team is obviously long past moral victories or anything like that, but was pretty impressive how you kept coming back in the fourth quarter. And again, even in overtime when you're down, I think, 9:40 seconds left and still kind of got back into it. I mean, does that in any way, you know, allow you to feel sort of good about what happened today? Or is that a positive you can take out of it?
I thought that's what I meant. I thought we executed some good things to give ourselves a chance to win.
Because it's the last game of the year, I guess, is maybe more.
Yeah.
If it was the middle of the season, I wouldn't ask you that question probably.
You know, it's nice to play with a Pac-12 team and be right there and feel like you're capable of beating them. You know, making a run, I think, gives us a little bit better feeling for sure. But it'll just be tough because I feel like we didn't play our best game today, and that'll be the thing that probably stays with me as a coach. I think we talked to the team in the locker room afterwards just about how good the year was and not to let themselves define it by 4 or 5 really close losses, although they're losses and that's the way it works. You know, like, I totally get that. But we were really close to being a very special team too, record-wise and everything else, and we just didn't quite get that done. So I'm pleased with what they did. They went through a lot this year and moved a lot of pieces around throughout the year, and it wasn't a cookie cutter, you know, just really easy thing. It was a tough year and went through a lot, but they did a lot of good things.
Kennedy Leonard's really good. Better
players
you face this year?
Yeah, I always stop short of saying that because there's so many good players. Right. But she's awful good. She played really well today. You know, I mean, yeah, she was really special today. Didn't come out, I don't think, either, did she?
I don't think so.
Didn't feel like she did. No, she played great. She had some big shots late. Overtime, she had that deep, 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 deep three. Had a pull-up jumper that went. That was tough, too. She made some big plays. Yeah, she was good.
Well, again, you know, what you were saying before about looking at this season as a whole, is it a successful season?
Yeah, I think so, very much so. I really do. There's some goals that we didn't accomplish that, you know, hopefully will stay with us for a while, and that's okay that we should be disappointed. I hope we are. But there's a lot of positive to it, too. Like I said earlier, we had to move a lot of things around to get to this point, and 5-6 possessions I could pick out from 5 different games, and then it's special. And it's just really hard to let those things define a season in a bad way. Had we come out on the other side of those, we're still the exact same team. You know, nothing has changed, but we probably feel differently. So I just don't want the team to feel poorly or down because some of those things didn't go our way. They still prevented us from achieving some of our goals, so we acknowledge that. But that doesn't necessarily mean the team, you know, didn't give it everything they had and didn't achieve a lot, I guess.
Well, I was going to say, like, going into next season then, I was going to ask, you know, does the season playing out the way it did, both with some of the close losses and the injury and that kind of stuff, does that humble your team? And I don't want to put it that way because it's not like your team needs to be humbled. They didn't, you know, do anything wrong necessarily. But the expectations were so high, you know, and then a few things happened that were kind of outside their control, changes things up a little bit. Will that in any way change how you approach next season?
Yeah, I don't think so. Like, I wouldn't use the word humbled for the reason you said. I don't think we were, I don't know what the exactly. I don't think we took anything for granted.
Right.
I don't think we had an arrogance to us, complacency to us. We just had some things that didn't go our way. And that's not sour grapes either. That means we got beat in those games by good teams. We're okay saying that. But I don't think it'll change our off-season approach. I really don't. I mean, I think we've always been hungry and we've been productive, and we'll just continue to try and move forward. And that's what's made us a good team over the years, not getting too up or down. Sometimes things just don't go the way you want them to, and that's a part of this thing. Doesn't mean we won't try and improve, but you know, next year's team will just be so very different. You know, it'll have some different pieces to it, and you know, so it won't be a continuation of this year, I guess. It'll be a new starting point, and we'll go from there.